When I first came to town, when I first got off that boat with $200 in my pocket, and when I got that job as a waiter at Middleton's Tavern, and when I saw that vacant shop behind Middleton's Tavern, I decided to do a coffee shop. And my girlfriend at the time, who is now my wife, gave me a little card for encouragement. And that card was an Oscar Wilde quote. And that quote said something like this, just in case I didn't get it quite right. It said, "Yes, I am a dreamer, for a dreamer makes his way by moonlight and sees the dawn before the rest of the world." I'm asking you to dream with me and make this one Annapolis.
This is us all walking the talk.
I campaigned as a change agent. I campaigned as a guy that's going to bring in new ideas. We are going to continue to try new ideas in this city. We have to make a city that is relevant for the next generation.
So when you do things like this and you make water cleaner and our air better and our environment that much stronger, we all benefit.
It's about bringing people together to decide on what your city should look like. And that's why it was important for me to put this event together today, so that we could sit here and try to reimagine what could happen here. But let's just make something that works for everybody. This morning at 7:16 a.m., I received a call from White House Press Secretary Sarah Huckabee Sanders informing me that President Trump would be issuing a proclamation to lower the United States flags to half-staff to honor the victims of the Capitol newspaper tragedy.
What a difference a day made.
This event is about healing. This event is about bringing people together. You know, we have an epidemic in our country, and that epidemic is unaddressed mental health issues combined with easy access to guns. We have to solve that as a community. With this event today is to show that we're not gonna let this stuff defeat us, that this thing is gonna make our city stronger.
Mr. These are the people who put out the paper. People have said to me, "I've done a great job." I haven't, they have.
My lonely nights are through dear.
Today, we have representatives from the multiple first responders that came to the scene. I want to, if anyone sees a first responder, I want them to hug them. Okay? So we're going to have a... we'll make it a hug a first responder day.
Kids show up when you speak to them. We have to start speaking to kids. And this is an example of what they can do.
It's up to us, as a community, to march, vote, and fight for our lives.
At the school, we always talk about building communities, and it's great that these young people right here can be here today so they can see how we do build communities.
And how we're moving into a brighter day and a brighter future.
Now is the time for all good men to get together with one another. I ask you to think of ways
that you too can shine a light on the values of a diverse community. There are simple ways you can do this. Speak up and make your voices heard. Be kind to a stranger and maybe even walk through a neighborhood unfamiliar to you and introduce yourself. Talk to your family and friends about ways we can help one another. Get involved in a community organization at your local school and help strengthen our community. Apply to serve on one of our city boards and commissions and help shape public policy. Here, we're very lucky to live in this city. I feel lucky every single day. But we're so lucky to live here. But we need to, you can't just stop. History doesn't just stop. You have to keep evolving. You have to keep reimagining. We need to move forward as a city to make progress together, to end the us versus them mentality. We all live in this city together. It has been important for our administration to set the tone with the theme of One Annapolis. The long time tale of two cities within Annapolis ends with me. The bottom line is, the trash needs to be collected and the streets need to be plowed. Mayors have the unique opportunity to roll up their sleeves and work together to solve problems here at home, where people care about one another. Mayors and city councils can be the change agents.